What's up, everybody? My name is Scott, and you're watching Kentucky Customs. And today we're going to try to fit some giant truck wheels on this PT Cruiser. This PT Cruiser has been sitting for a while, and we think a mouse has made its home in it because, well, of course, you can't tell on camera, but it smells like mouse pee really bad. Yeah, it's bad. Or it could be where Dad left the dip can in here. I don't know, but I'm gonna go with a mouse.
Yep.
It's the dip can?
Yep.
I'm just gonna take your word for it. I don't wanna smell it.
No, go ahead.
No, I'm good. No.
It is. That's exactly what it is. That smells like pure death.
Gross.
Pure death.
So the wheels that are on here right now, what are these, Dad, like 17s?
These are 17-inch rims.
17-inch rims.
All the way around it, yep.
And these wheels here, they're pretty small. So I have 18-inch wheels with 37-inch tires. And we're gonna try to fit them on there. So this is a 5-lug, but in this box, I have conversion spacers from 5 to 6-lug. And then I've got other wheel spacers that we're gonna put on here. So it's gonna bring the wheels out really far, and then we're gonna see if we can get them to fit on there. So here's the conversion spacer from 5 to 6 lugs. We're gonna jack this thing up and start with the back wheels.
My car's smelling better already. Did you spray something in there?
I did.
There you go. Not gonna lie, I've been pretty excited about this. These came in, and then I had to go on a trip, so I was gone for like 4 or 5 days, and they've just been sitting there waiting, and I could not wait to get back and put these things on here. This isn't sketchy at all.
No.
This is totally fine.
This is great.
So now we gotta slip this on here. Now this should just fit on there.
Sorry.
Bruh, you're using 2 hands, I'm using 1. That's not fair.
Bruh! Okay.
You think those are good?
Yeah.
You'd trust that down the road?
I would trust that on the road.
All right, well, let's go get a wheel.
So, I measured 2 4-wheelers. And both 4-wheelers had 26-inch diameter tires on them.
Mm-hmm.
But from here to here on ours, 24 and a half. So I was getting this tire, which is a Kenda Bear Claw, is true to size. This is 26 inches from here to here. I did not know that.
He done went and spent $650 on tires we can't use. He swears that we can get them on here, but I don't think so.
Those are gonna go. See, you put a 2-inch lift on this, we're gonna do some trimming. That's gonna go right on that car.
Yeah, you're probably right. And we can always put some sort of spacer on there too.
Yeah, $750. That's what they cost.
$750 for all 4 of those?
Yeah.
That's what we paid?
Yeah.
Oh, we're gonna get them on that car. We got the adapters on there, so now we're at 6-lug.
Yeah.
But we're going to try to avoid cutting this. We're gonna put about another 4 inches of spacers on that. The front is all I'm really concerned with. So let's say we bring them out and then it won't turn. We can just cut a lot of that, can't we?
Yeah, you can, and that's what I'll be doing to the smart car. Actually, there'll be a spot cut out so that the front wheel can turn and won't rub the side of the quarter panels.
Cool, so we'll just cut and beat the crap out of this thing if we have to. Oh, dear. That's going to be awesome. And then we got one more. Yeah, that's going to bring it out past the wheel well. The wheel's going to clear it after this next one. Like... This is totally not safe. Not safe at all, but it's gonna be cool.
These are kind of cheap spacers also, so I won't be surprised if when I decide to take this thing in a creek that something just breaks. All right, well, after we put this one on, we'll be able to see how the wheel fits on here. Here, I'm gonna help hold that while you.
Maybe not. Probably gonna lose an arm.
I think we're ready for a wheel, and that. Yeah. I don't think. Yeah, it's gonna bring it out past the wheel well. This technically should work. Technically. How far is that?
Right,
almost six inches.
Yep.
Okay, we're gonna have to jack the car up maybe a little more, get that to fit.
How's that?
Let me see. I think that's probably gonna be good. Hold on. This is awesome. I think that, oh no.
What?
I don't think it's gonna work.
Why not?
We have 6 inches of wheel spacer on here right now, and it's not going to work because those wheels, it's going to take about another 4 to 6 inches for it not to rub here. So we're going to put some more spacers on.
I can take this part off if you want me to.
Take Let's take this off too, and we'll put these on, and then we'll see where we're at. Yep. Yeah, I think I have underestimated how many wheel spacers I was going to need for this. All right, this might work.
And it might not.
I don't think it's gonna. No.
And
no,
we're gonna. It's not gonna work because why?
Well, for one, that's not all the way. I think one more wheel spacer will do it. I think one more.
Oh my gosh. Well, let's see what we're going for.
Where are we at now? We're at almost 8. If this doesn't do it, we're gonna at least get the backs on today, and then I have to wait for the fronts. So we may just put the backs on. Looks totally safe, 100% safe. Okay, we've got about 10 inches of spacer on here now, and we removed the little fender flare, so I'm hoping we can get the wheel on now. Oh, it's on. Oh my gosh. We can totally put that back on. We gotta put that back on.
Okay.
We'll put the wheel on first. People say that PT Cruisers aren't cool, but this one's gonna be pretty cool. I think it's gonna spin okay. Yeah. Okay, we got all those on. Now, let me put the caps on.
Oh,
like that. Well, we got one on there.
Rolls really good.
Okay, well, we got that on there. I mean, totally not sketch at all. But it actually looks pretty good, and I kind of like the way it looks with the little wheel on the front. But
I do too, because it's black and black. We matched them up really well.
Yeah, it looks good. I think I still want to try to get the fronts on there, so I'm gonna have to order more spacers. But for now, we're gonna repeat the process real quick, and then we'll show you the end result. We got both wheels on there, so we're gonna go ahead and put the jack down, and it didn't break off. That's good.
Oh my God.
Wow. I don't even know if we could drive this down the road.
The horse likes it.
What do you think? I think it looks pretty cool. I kind of want to put the front wheels on too, though. I don't know. We'll keep it like this for a little bit. I'm gonna have to order more wheel spacers anyways. I'm gonna drive it around a little bit. It's front wheel drive, so we can't really peel out. Only the front wheels will peel out. It didn't break off, so that's good.
Ridiculous.
Seemed to be on there pretty good.
Dad's gonna go try it out. Oh my gosh. This one over here almost seems kind of wobbly. Looks kind of funky. Well, that one's doing it too. I think it's just the shocks. I think it's just the shocks. I think it's just like they're hitting bumps and they're moving. I don't think that it's like...
You were in it. I saw the same thing. I thought they looked loose, but then after watching it, I think it's just the suspension, and they're hung out so far, they just look like they're loose.
Yeah.
But they're not.
I think they're okay. All right, well, that's going to be it for today. We got the back wheels on. I think it looks pretty cool, but I still want to put the wheels on the front too and see if we can get those to work. What do you think about it, and what do you think we should do? Should we go ahead and put the truck tires on the front too? Or just leave the back ones on? Leave your answers in the comment section down below. Thanks so much for watching Kentucky Customs. Hit that subscribe button, hit that like button. As always, his name is Scott, my name is Scott, and we'll see you next time.